Hi, my name is Bob Rowe. I'm the Executive Director of the East Coast Shellfish Growers Association. I'm here to talk to you today about how we harvest and grow our shellfish, how we process them, and some of the considerations you might want to have when you receive these shellfish coming from the U.S. Our shellfish rules are determined by a group called the Interstate Shellfish Sanitation Conference that is composed of the state regulatory authorities, usually the State Department of Health or maybe Fisheries or Ag, and overseen by the Food and Drug Administration. Our states monitor water quality on a very regular basis. The very good news is that we're doing a great job. Every single container of shellfish has to be tagged. One on each container, a waterproof tag that contains information including the harvest area, the date, the harvester's information, and that has to be retained on each container until it's used. All harvesters are licensed and must undergo training so that they understand the rules about tagging and most importantly about product handling to ensure food safety. For instance, strict cooling requirements in every state require that shellfish go on ice, often within an hour of harvest, to ensure that they are kept cold and there's no post-harvest growth of bacteria. Dealers are also highly regulated in the U.S., and only a permitted licensed dealer can sell shellfish. Some of the larger farms are also shellfish dealers. They have twice annual inspections with rigid requirements covering everything from facility construction to practices and sanitation, and they have a 3-day training requirement. It's called HACCP, or Hazard Analysis and Critical Control Point Training, to ensure that they understand all of the potential sources of contamination. In the U.S., we have strict record-keeping requirements that allow us to do a full traceback following a bag of oysters from its harvest place to where it's consumed. So should an illness outbreak occur, we have the means to do a full traceback and potentially recall any contaminated products. Of course, when you're shipping shellfish, especially oysters, air freight requires special packaging, gel packs, plastic lined boxes. Under ideal circumstances, the containers that are on the plane are also refrigerated. It's important to have timely handling by port agents and customs officials to ensure that the product gets there promptly. The Eastern American oyster is a very hardy species. Unlike Crassostrea gigas, the Pacific or Japanese oyster, the Eastern oyster has a very long shelf life and does not tend to dry out. In winter, you can actually hold an Eastern oyster under refrigeration for quite a long time. Summer oysters should probably be consumed within 2 weeks or preferably less. So what should you know when you receive American oysters? The Eastern oyster, the most important thing about it is that the oyster should be kept cold, below 10 degrees centigrade, to avoid post-harvest bacterial growth. Of course, you don't want to freeze them either. You want to keep the tags associated with the product. These are animals, they need to breathe, so don't put them in an airtight container. And if you expect to hold them for more than a few days, pack them cupside down in a moist environment because they might need to breathe. Always store the American oyster in dry refrigeration, not in tanks of seawater, and keep the tag so that if there is an illness, you can do a trace back to the harvest area. It's food as nature intended. It's really unembellished, totally natural, fresh, and delicious. For more information on how you can source American oysters, contact Food Export USA Northeast.